Hi, I'm Tim Green, and tonight I'm going to show you how to add a new wick and wire coil to the RTA, that's the Repairable Tank Atomiser by Clockworks. Now this is using the wick from the group buy on UKVapers that I had going on there, so a lot of you have got wick out there, and it's slightly different to what you're used to, so I thought do some videos just to help you along. So let's have a take a look at what you're going to need. All sorts here at the moment. Right, well obviously you've got the RTA and a drip tip, a syringe to fill the RTA, I'll put that to one side for the moment, and obviously some juice. The actual tools you'll need to add a new atomizer coil are some scissors, a small Phillips head screwdriver. This is one of those screwdrivers that you'd get in a small precision screwdriver set. I have a pair of surgical steel tweezers here that I'll use if I need to. Sometimes if I get a lot of juice on my fingers, I'll need to use some tweezers. I have here, if I can pick the thing up, this is a paper clip. You can see that with just one part of it that's been straightened out, and that's for wrapping the wire and making the coil. I have a sharp knife. So don't forget to ask parental permission, or have a parent, an adult supervise you while doing this. Joke. Right, this is 3mm wick. This is 3mm diameter wick, and this is the 1mm diameter wick. Now, if you've got an RTA, the chances are that you're going to have this wick. So that's the wick that I'm going to use. The principle and process is exactly the same, regardless of the wick. You just need to use a little less of the thicker one, but I'll show you what I mean in a moment. Obviously I have my mod for testing. I'm using the Provari for this just so that you can see the ohmage that the coil works out at the end, and we can work with that. Okay, so first things first, the RTA. Now I've already taken this apart, given it a good clean, a bit more of a clean than I would normally do. What I actually did was actually completely dismantled it so that I could give it a flush out with water and dry it off. The sharp knife really is only there if you struggle a little to take this top part off. Now I don't usually say that, I'm on camera so I might now, but what you need to do first of all, I'll just try and turn my light back on to try and make things easier. First of all, you need to take this top section off. Now all I usually do is here, and it's coming off, so that's fine, just wiggle that about a bit and off it comes. You see here, you've got your two terminals and a number of holes. Now when it first comes, some of you will have found that it'll have had wick in all the holes. Using this wick, this new wick, I found that I don't need to have any wick going into the third hole. However, it's a good idea to use it because that can become a source of leakage if you're not careful. But we'll go into that in a second. So, in your positive and negative terminals, now you use the precision screwdriver just to open those up. Obviously, if you've just received an RTA and it's not wired wicked up, then you'll be fine. You'll be like at this stage now. If you've had one before and it did come with a wick attached, a coil attached, you're going to need to remove that, so it's just a case of unscrewing these and pull it all out. It leaves you with your arrangement like this. So, first things first, we need to make sure that we've got enough wick. Now I'm just taking some of the wick from here. I'm going to make a guesstimate of how much I'm going to use as far as the length is concerned. So, it only needs to be approximate. You know, nothing scientific about this. It's actually a very similar process, the way that I do it, on the IATI as well. So, all I did there was I just measured the rough area over the top there with the edge of the wick. I've got my wick length in there now, and I will just cut this off like so, and that's the piece of wick. Now, as you'll see, the wick starts to kind of unfurl, and you want it to do that, so we'll just take it apart. There's one, two, three, four. Now, the way that I do this, I actually only need two pieces, so the other two will come in for the next time. So keep those safe. Now these two will form the wick that feeds the main atomizer section. Now what I'm going to do here is I'm just going to roughly find whereabouts the middle is. That's where I'm going to be wrapping my coil. Okay, so first things first. This is nickel chrome or nichrome wire. This is 38 SWG or it's 0.15 millimeters. You won't have received wire like this. This is an 840 meter roll of wire. Just to make sure that I'm never going to run out. Now, 0.15 nickel chrome wire has a resistance of 60 ohms per meter. So that is 0.6 ohms per centimeter. Now, based on that, we can work out that if you want a low resistance coil of about 1.5 ohms, then you don't need any, you need to make the coil out of around 3 centimeters. That'd give you a coil of 1.8 ohms. So what I do is cut off about 4 centimeters of wire, and that allows me some trim off space and obviously the legs of the wire to go into the posts. So I roughly used to use a little rule. And I'll turn my light back on. A little rule. 4 centimeters. It's not very much wire at all. Now, some people prefer to keep the wire attached onto something else. It makes it easier for them to handle it. I am so used to handling it now, I will cut off my length. That's all the wire that I'll need. Just this one small piece, if I can pick the thing up. There we go. That's 1 4-centimeter length of nichrome wire. So, take my paperclip and use this part here as a handle just to steady my grip. And I will put the centre of the wick there, close to the handle. So that means I get a good grip there. Take my piece of wire, if I can pick it up, and hold one end under my thumb, like so. And then, because we know what the resistance of that wire is, roughly, we don't have to worry about the number of coils. So as many coils as you can squeeze out of it, basically. The larger the coil, the more effective the atomizer. So that's one, and we'll do these quite tight. I apologize if my camera doesn't show the wire very well on here. It's not really meant for detailed work, but we make do. I hope you can see it. And I'm not pulling tightly on the wire, because if you pull tightly, what I find is that it actually just pulls the wick around whatever it is you're turning the wire around, because you can equally do this around a nail or a pin, safety pin or something like that. Now this first one is always a little bit out because that's the bit I was holding with my thumb. I've now changed my grip, so I will readjust that one, make that nice and neat. Down like that. Got my two legs, and I have here 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 turns of wire. Okay, and what I'll do now is I'll just slide that a little towards the end. That's just to help me when I'm fitting it to the RTA. Now comes fitting it in here. The way that I do this is I hold on to the paper clip as I have been doing, straighten the legs out a little bit, and what I do is I try to thread both of the legs through at the same time. It's a little tricky, but I find that once I get them in, they're in, and then it's just a matter of being quick with a screwdriver. Now what I'm doing now is I'm just making sure that the legs are both straight, so there's no bouncing off anything else. And if you look, I've got the alignment pretty much right there. So one leg is slightly longer than the other. That again is by design, because then I can get one leg in first and then the other without knocking out the first. And then I push those through like so, and holding it in place with my thumb here, I can now just screw in. Now you don't want to screw tight because of these terminals. You only need to really just pinch it, doesn't need to be any more than that, because if you put too much stress on it at this point, if you tighten it right up, you'll pull more wire through and break the wire on the coil. Sometimes you don't even notice. I know this because I've done it many times myself. Note that I said many. Don't always learn from the mistakes, but there you go. Now all I'm going to do now is I'm just going to trim the legs off the wire just as the light goes out. Excuse me. There we have, nicely trimmed. It's important to trim these wires off because you don't want any long lengths touching the other terminal, and you don't want it touching the side. Especially you don't want both of them touching the side, you'll just short things out. But as you see there, I've got wick and wire arrangement all nice and ready. Now at this stage what I'm going to do is I'm going to put my thumb over the coil and gently, see, I'm not pushing down on my thumb, I'm just going to gently pull out that paper clip, and that leaves us with our wick and wire. Now you'll see if I pull on the wick, you see the wick, you don't, now some people would be horrified at that, I think, and want to know why it's not tighter. I found that if you tighten the wire too much, it actually starts to burn through the wick, a bit like a cheese wire, and the wick disintegrates, especially if you like vaping higher voltages or if you're a chain vapor like myself. So now the next job is to actually thread the wick into the holes. Now, the easiest way to do this is to wet the wick just a little bit. So just wet the tip. And what I'm going to do now is I am quite literally going to thread that in. It's a little difficult because with the overhead light now I can't properly see the hole. See what I did there? I nearly pulled the wick all the way out. That would have been really clever not. Okay, I'm going to resort to using the tweezers for this. You don't have to. You don't necessarily have to do it this way. I'm doing it this way purely to make sure that I actually do it within a realistic time frame. I'm also concentrating on filming and lights and everything else, so now some people say, oh, I've got a simple way of doing that, fine. This is just the way that I do it. And if you have a simpler way, then by all means share it with everybody on the forum. Clockworks himself may well have a simpler way of doing it. This is just the way I do it. Now you see I've got both in, and I just need to feed it into the hole. Same the second with the other side. And what I'm going to do here is I'm just going to wet, get a little bit of a twist, which I should have done the first time around, but there you go. This is like live TV. Does require a little bit of patience. I'm sure, there we go, you see straight in that time. This, I will say, is only like the third time that I've re-whipped this, because one of the beauties of this system is you don't have to do the wick that often. So there we go. Nice and simple. Now, if you find that at higher voltages it's not wicking enough, then what you do is you can put another wick in here, and that's the way that Steve originally supplies it. Clockworks originally supplies it. He'll supply it with an extra wick in there, but that's using the standard 1mm wick that comes from Setting or Bully. So anyway, that's that one done. If you feel you need to, I mean, I haven't been doing, but if you feel you need to, you can bung that hole with some wick just for the sake of having something in there. I tend to stand my mods up, or if they go into my pocket, they'll go into my pocket with this thing this way up. So what I'm going to do, put that on. Actually, tell you what, we'll take that bit off and we'll show you the resistance. Okay, Atomiser ohmage. Okay, so that's 2.3 ohms. Slightly overdid it with the wire then, in that case. But that's okay, because I'm on a variable voltage mod. At 2.3 ohms, I'll just vape it into about 4.6 volts. Time to fill it up. Let me take the screw out. Just going to lie that down. And I'm going to use some new juice that I got. Some of Griswold's licorice tobacco. So, and what I do is I actually fill it in from the top like this, and that way I can get as much juice as I can in. Now that's a 1 mil syringe, so 1 mil's gone in. I'll just put 2 mils worth in here. In there. And there we are. 2 mil of juice. You notice how clean? I've not used a tissue yet. So that's a good sign. Now this is hard, holding a mod and trying to put that screw in. Normally that's not the case. Obviously I'm looking at this through a viewfinder. So there we go. So it's a bit more of a, there we go. Right. So the only thing left to do now is add drip tip. Like so. Let's vape and see how it does. So this is the Clockworks RTA, that's a repairable tank atomizer. With a fresh wick and with a fresh coil, filled up, ready to go, and just check the voltage on the Provari. It's at 4.6 volts. See how she vapes. Take the voltage down a little bit on that, the flavour hit is just so intense. Light went off on the other thing. Okay, take it down to 4.4 volts. Wicks instantly, and performs really, really well. Getting a bit of a nicotine hit now at the moment, because the one thing that you will find with this is that the an 18 milligram juice will taste like a 24 or 36 milligram juice, which gives you the opportunity to actually drop down a couple of notches of your nicotine yourself. And this performs fantastically. I hope you found the video useful. I shall do another one with the repairable dripping atomizer again by Clockworks. Anyway, and if you're watching this and you've taken part in the group buy for Repairable Atomiser Wick, thanks very much, and I'll see you on the forum. Bye for now.